Gorgeous, that's what you want to say when you hear about the new Volvo XC90. The car should deliver a lot, but you never know what the car is capable of before you drove it. So now, let's see how it drives.
The Swedes have revamped and redesigned their upper-class all-rounder, giving him all kinds of new equipment. But the changes are most noticeable when driving. The Nordic developers have obviously done a great job. The most fuel-efficient of the three different XC90's available engines uses as little as 2.1 litres of fuel per 100 kilometres, the plug-in hybrid T8. In addition to the plug-in hybrid, as a top drive you can have the XC90 T6 petrol engine with 320 bhp, or the twin-turbo D5 diesel with 225 bhp. The high torque and economical diesel features as the entry-level model, available from Volvo for €53,400.
All engines of the new range of XC90 are four-cylinder engines. The different level of power comes from things like turbocharged different petrols and plug-in hybrid. If you prefer the characteristic of a six-cylinder engine, that wouldn't be there, but it still works fine.
The XC90 is Volvo's first model based on its new platform, on which more models will be built in future. Powerful lines work well to make the huge, almost 5-meter-long, 2.3-ton Colossus appear more subtle and less obtrusive. You can fit up to 7 people in the XC90 in comfort, thanks to its raised seating position and large windows.
That the new Volvo XC90 should deliver a lot of space in the interior is clear as soon as you see the dimensions of the car. But how much space you're gonna see here? This seat here fits my dimensions, and still I have plenty of space here at my knees. There's a nice head space here, and if you go on longer trips you can adjust the seat, and that's very comfortable.
The optional third row of seats is really best for children. Alternatively, in a five-seat configuration, you can have between 721 and 1,886 litres of luggage space. By far the best seller among the three different available engines of the Volvo XC90 will be the D5 diesel. Volvo expects it will achieve up to 85% of all sales. Inside, there is an understated elegance. Volvo have reduced the number of knobs and controls to the bare minimum. This has been especially helped with the use of a touchpad with gesture recognition familiar to users of tablets and smartphones.
The interior of the new XC90 is not only very spacious, it is all well built. We have nice materials here, everything is the way it should be in a premium SUV. A very nice feature is this new big touchpad here in the middle. This touchpad controls nearly every function in the car, but it takes some time to get used to.
An 8-speed automatic gearbox transfers the engine power to a 4-wheel drive, which normally sends most of the power forward and up to 50% of its torque to the rear wheels when needed. An optional air suspension can lower the rear for easier entry. A new electric power steering could be a little more soulful. With many optional extras available, the entry price of the XC90 models can easily increase by €10,000 or more.
Volvo got big plans. They want to increase sales up to 2020 from now about 500,000 units to then 800,000 units a year. The new XC90 is a very important part of the plan, and customers waited about 12 years for this new version. The good thing is it delivers everything you expect from a premium SUV. The price starts at about €53,000. That's not cheap, but for that car it's quite fair.